Hi, my name is Steve. I take care of birds for a living. I'm out here feeding the ducks and geese. We're going to be learning about the interesting adaptations that make both of them so well-suited for their aquatic environment. They can swim, they can fly, they can walk, and they can basically do it all. So we're going to be learning about that.
What the duck? Ducks are well adapted to their lives in and near water. They have webbed feet for swimming. Their legs are situated further back on their bodies to help them dive, even though it gives them their famous waddle. There's a lot of variety in their feathers. All of these are ducks. The duck shape is good for any bird that lives near water, so there's many other things that get confused with ducks. These things are not ducks. Cormorant, gallinule, swan, coot, grebe, loon, goose, rubber duck, duckface. Ducks can walk and fly, but they seem most comfortable while swimming. Their webbed feet help them get food. There are two main feeding strategies in ducks. Dabbling ducks scoop up a mouthful of water, then strain it with their beaks to get food particles. Their beaks tend to be flat and broad. Diving ducks go further down to grab a mouthful of algae or maybe a fish. Their beaks are more straight and pointed. Check out my very first video to learn more about beak shapes. Diving ducks have feet even further back on their body for underwater swimming, but this makes them more awkward while walking on land. Like many birds, ducks have an oil gland at the top of their tail. They dab some oil from their gland and wipe it on their feathers. This makes their feathers water resistant, keeping them dry and floating. It's hard to talk about ducks without a discussion of ducklings. Their babies are precocial, so they are able to see, walk, and find food within minutes of hatching. It's common to see a number of ducklings following a mother around. These ducklings have one task: grow large enough to migrate before the cold season. They follow their mother and eat grass and bugs. Ducklings are able to fly just 60 days after hatching.
If you ever decide to go out feeding ducks, it's important to know that bread is not an appropriate food for them. It doesn't have the nutrients they need. So we've brought along a wild bird seed mix so that it has more complete nutrition for them.
Bonus ducks! These are just ducks that have really cool names, and I wanted to read them even though I'm not totally sure how to pronounce all of them, but let's give it a shot. Widgeon, Golden Eye, Gargany, the Fulvous Whistling Duck, Smew, Scoter, Shoveler, and Bufflehead. It's just a delightful set of names. Whoever named ducks, good job. So now, if anyone asks, you can tell them what the duck. Before you duck and run, be sure to dabble through some other videos or dive on the subscribe button.